just in my backyard, and just back from a recent canoe trip. This is a brand new canoe that I got from Mountain Equipment Co-op. It's a Novacraft Prospector, and it's 16 foot in Aramid Lite. I got a very good discount on it because it's got a crack on the clear coat. It was damaged in shipping. So I'm going to add some skid plates and just touch up a little bit of another kind of damaged crack that happened. Neither of them caused the canoe to leak in any way, so there's no issues. I'm hoping this will be an easy job. I've got skid plates, epoxy system, some pumps. I've never done this before, so this is going to be a bit of an experiment. I've watched the YouTube video of how to do it a few times, so let's see how it goes. So here's the damage that I'm talking about. Looks like they must have slid it off the truck, banged it into something. So the gel coat there is a couple of millimeters thick, maybe slightly thicker. That's really all that's damaged, but because I'm putting the skid plate on, that's going to cover up that whole area. Okay, so this is what apparently I need, the Novacraft skid plates. Basically a fabric, the West System 105 epoxy resin. Oh, you know what? Why don't I do it this way? West System 206 hardener, which is apparently the one recommended. It's a slower hardener. Drop sheet, I'm gonna put plastic around. This is a pump system, one pump for each. So you put a smaller pump on the hardener and the bigger, larger pump on the resin, one each, and that it measures it for you, which is definitely required for me. Got some masking tape to mask up the area, brush to apply, and some sandpaper. So what I'm doing here is basically marking out the spot where I'm going to apply all this resin. And I'm just using the skid plate itself as a marker. I'm going to be cutting that off, well, just taking it off by the tape here in a minute. I could not find an X-Acto knife. Masking tape, if you can see that. There we go. So the drop sheet I'm using is so massive, I'm actually just going to wrap it underneath. So I just got to tape it on there, maybe about here. I'm just going to wrap it up and underneath. Sandpaper time. I've got 150 grit. It recommends 100, but this is what I've got. So I tried to get as tight to the tape lines as possible, and I think I've achieved that. I guess now I've got to go research how to do the resin part. So the manual says prepare both sides at the same time. I guess that makes sense, that way you only have mixing the epoxy once. So I'm going to do that. I'm not going to bother filming it. It's at the other end. And I'll come back in a bit. Okay, pretty much finished taping off the plate area and sanding it down with that little bit of sandpaper on either side. Now this is a bonus damage area that came from MEC. They didn't even know about it. I bought the boat and I found it after. But you know what? It's not a big deal. I'm just going to, it's just kind of a crack in the clear coat. That's it there. So I'm just going to tape off an area and just use a little bit of the epoxy, kind of shore that up. I'm going to do the same on the inside, but probably won't show that. Okay, it's now time for the scary part. I'm going to mix the resins and then start applying it with paintbrush and then put the skid plate on top of that, and then wet the skid plate with the paintbrush with the resin again, trying to squeeze out all the air bubbles. So it looked easy on YouTube. We'll see what it's like with this. I'll just mix her up. Try not to breathe in too much of it. Yes, here we go. It says coat it. Get out of here, bug. Come on. It says to coat liberally. And since the skid plate has to stick down to it, and I have quite a bit of resin, I think I will do as much or more as possible. I'm pretty certain I'm going to need to mix some more resin. But here goes nothing. Just sort of, I don't know if you can see that, but you can just shift it forward. And it's tacky enough, it's holding itself in place. So. Alright, so I've done both the front and the back. Skid plates are all on. It looks like there's no bubbles, like no white anywhere I can see. There's a little bit of this. Having that on there was a great idea because I didn't realize how much the glue would run. Let's see if I can get you in here. Oop, sorry. So that's all drips from the glue going down, and where I repaired this little spot here is where I've noticed it. I just had to wipe up the side of the canoe. It had dribbled all the way down. It seemed to wipe off pretty nice. Okay, so that's both skid plates on. I gotta wait about 4 hours now for the epoxy to cure, then I can take off all the plastic and just see if it's gonna look okay. But I mean, really, it's basically gonna look exactly like that. So I'm pretty happy with it. And the boat was yellow, kind of a pale yellow, and the skid plates come that color, so I didn't even have to worry about any tinting. The epoxy, never used it before. It's got these little pumps on. I highly recommend those. They're about 20 bucks. Like I said in the comments, I wasn't sure what epoxy to use. West Systems 105 resin, 206 hardener is what was recommended. And it seemed to work out pretty darn good. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it's a little bit informative. And if you were thinking about putting skid plates on but not really sure where to start, this is my first time. It went pretty well. If you're interested in canoeing or camping videos, check out my other stuff. The first voyage of this thing was just 2 weeks ago. And this skid plate's completely repaired that chip that was out of the front. So, pretty happy with it so far.